fighting a warrior, so let's see how this deck does in the mirror. So far, we got the good 2-drop. So what kind of warrior are we fighting? The alpha play, bro. This is the most alpha warrior play. Alright, so he's drawing a weapon. Well, I mean, I still have to do this. I don't enjoy having to do it, but I gotta do it. I have a lot of pirates in the deck, but I think I'm still just gonna go with the Livewire Lance. I'm gonna have to like probably try to out skipper value him, aren't I? Oh, I gotta play this. It really sucks that I have to do this, but I need to get these pirates out of my deck. I could coin Captain Greenskin actually. That might be a decent play. Oh, yeah, so the pirates. Good to know. You missed out on a lot of value, actually. That's so good for me. Lucky for me, I've got a lot of pirates in my deck. To think pirates will be used for control. Sword of Mord! Becoming more of an actual card people are playing. It's good against Demon Hunter. Makes sense. Alright, last pirate in our deck I think is another one of these guys. Okay. Well, he did it, so am I. I doubt he's got weapon destruction, right? So, like, the thing I'm slowly realizing with this matchup is that if he doesn't, like, have these epic skipper turns, then I can just easily just keep generating boards that he can't deal with. And if I can get my other Armorsmith, then this game just might be over. Go for the value right now. Ooh, Norse Dorm is gonna be so good in this matchup because he won't be able to think about his plays. The next level dragon pick. Norse Dorm is actually gonna win this game. Calling it right now. Hot take. Calling it right now. Norse Dorm is gonna win this game. Turn 9, play Norse Dorm. He's gonna be like, how do I kill that? Gotta think, gotta wait for risky skipper animations. Alright. Rope. Oh, this is happening now. So we do this, the hero power. Just gonna make sure that we can like outvalue him in every single possible way. I'm actually gonna go Brightwing. I have so much value right now. It's also like a decent low tempo card. Or not low tempo card, low cost card. More resources, more ways to win. Dude, this deck. This could be a, like, this deck could maybe be good. Because I actually feel pretty good against the mirror. As long as we get our hero power going, like, suddenly we have the initiative. They gotta start playing around our 4-3s literally every single turn. 2 4-3s. This might be, like, the great mid-range quest. The ultimate anti-trump card? Hell yeah, man. I mean, it's pretty much our trump card. Cleave, cool, we get 2 more life. And the Armorsmith survives. Why didn't we trade to the Armorsmith first, actually? We just gave me 2 unnecessary life. In this matchup, you don't want to give me more life. Norsdormu, hit in the field, next turn. Like, I'm slightly worried about a potential turn with the brutes, but I have ways of killing them. So I don't think it'll be that much of a concern. But it looks like we may not be able to get the Norsdormu out, depending on what happens here. This is both of his skippers gone now, so we won't have to like think about like the complicated turns. At least not as much. Are they going for the brutes though? So we do it this way, so we build up the board. I am the Egg Warrior now. All I needed this entire time was the egg. How many eggs can you get to the end of the game? How many eggs does it take to win the entire game? Lots of eggs. I really can't do that voice very well. My brother was doing it earlier, now it's stuck in my head. Essentially, no. We're pretty much just quoting the Turbopathic guy from Wreck-It Ralph. Turbopathic. Wait. Biggest galaxy brain play. Deal with it. I'm ready. Norsdormu winning this game right now. better make a play. Oh, come on. Not fair. No fun. My big dragon suddenly doesn't mean anything anymore. You got another shield slam in hand, right? I think I'll take it. I'm gonna take this damage, no matter what way I look at it. So I feel like I should go for the Blade Storm. Okay. I couldn't even kill it with the Molten Breath either, man. I really wanted to pick the Dragon Queen, but now that I know that it's in his hand, it'll give me information in his deck. Goes for two draws. Okay, Molten Breath is gone. I know that he has one of these. That's good for me. Dude, I love this deck. The more I play this deck, the more I'm slowly falling in love with it. Slowly but surely. Still have more lackeys, so I don't have to worry about like not getting value out of this, but like, do I even really need this guy? This might be for the rogue matchup. The rogue matchup actually might be a lot of fun, now that I'm like thinking about it. Value. Might as well just call this Value Warrior, bro, or Hack Warrior. I like Hack Warrior the most. Like, how are you not entertained by watching this? This is so cool. I've never seen this quest actually get any kind of recognition whatsoever. Then suddenly Kibler comes out of nowhere. He's like, hey, check out this deck. I'm like, oh, what? What is this madness? You're telling me you play 4/3s? Quest Rogue played 4/4s. 4/3s? It can't nearly be as good. You know, we just go with this to build up the board at the moment. We just have so many answers in our hand. If he plays Dragon Queen, we could probably trade into two of the dragons very, very easily. Does he still not play the Dragon Queen? What duplicate's still in his deck? Dude, what dragon is still in his deck? Trade here. Maximize the board so that way we can absolutely dominate his Alexstrasza play. Alive! think I'd just still keep going for the out value. Like, why would I push face here? Because if he could trade this and suddenly I can't kill this, and that's a problem. At the same time, I could get a 2 damage lackey. Nah. I went for the wrong play. See what comes out of this real quick before I hit face. Now we can hit face. We can hit face. We're putting him on the clock right now. One 4-3 is enough, because actually we already have another 4-3 with this guy and he gives us a 10 turn. Zephyrs, okay. So hit my face. Zephyr is into twisting. So I can have a whole board full of 4/4s and maybe almost a whole board full of 4/4s. Essentially 4 attack minion. 4 attack minions plus maybe a lackey. If I can get the live wire lance. We pick twisting here every time, my guy. But yeah, be sure to hit face. Or if you want to trade to the 0/2. Oh, Shadow Flame. Yeah, we'll be fine. We're still dominating the board completely. Which is exactly what we want. He's gotta play Dragon Queen this turn. We still have a Brawl left in our deck. We have Twin Tyrant. There it is. They're all 8/8s, they'll die to the Blade Storm if I can trade properly. Wait. Okay, alright. So I could still kill this. I can still kill this board. I can still kill this board. Yeah, I can still kill this board. I'm gonna take 7 though, no matter what way I look at it. Unless, hold on, what's the best way I can do this? I can't play Twin Tyrant because then I can't get the value out of that. So I guess we gotta take the damage. Wait, no we don't, we can do it this way. This is why we think, boys. Alright, this game's over. GG. Hack Warrior. We just hacked your deck out of options. That's where it gets its name. Oh. Okay, we have 5 cards in our deck? Is there any way that I can discover an Archivist Lysianna with lackeys? What warrior spell would I need? I don't think there's a warrior spell that, like, discovers Battlecry minions, but Lysianna? Really, dude? Oh my god. Can we outvalue Lysianna? Because he's gonna be top-decking options. I don't want card draw right now, man. These are all bad. Oh, okay, I can evolve this guy so I don't have to draw. More minions, nice. Alright, I can maybe clutch this. This is a very fickle game right now. Really? I guess he didn't have good options. We outvalued Elysiana, let's go! Ah. Ultimate Warrior deck. Oh, he didn't get the 420. Come on. 419, how you gonna do me like that game?